road to WAC Vegas. Excited to have Dixie State University's men's basketball head coach Jon Judkins on with us. Coach, how are you today?
I'm doing great. Good to have you.
Yeah. It's obviously been an extremely tough year for everybody, but what's been one of the hardest struggles for you and your team?
Knowing if you're going to play or not. That's been the hardest. You know, you prepare, and you got to remember this, these kids are 17, 18, 19 year olds, some of these guys, and they get all up for a game, and then all of a sudden the day before, oh, the game's canceled, and they kind of drop their head like, oh, I'm so excited to play, and then the next day it's, okay, we're going to play this weekend, and then you don't, you know, and so it's just really hard to they want to play so bad, and then they get the bad news that it's being canceled. That's been probably the hardest. Second one is obviously playing in front of fans. You know, the games we've had played here, we have up to 1,000 fans is what we can have. We haven't had that yet, but it's been hard. Our guys coming out, and there's just not that energy that fans bring to the game. You have to do it yourself, your team. And that part's been kind of good, though. It's made us communicate better and to do things to get us more, have more energy in the game. But those are kind of been the hardest. Obviously, our last road trip was hard. First time being on the road, first time playing back-to-back games, which was a different thing for us with injuries and soreness. And it's a tough to go back-to-back. But I thought our guys played a lot better on Saturday than we did Friday. So who knows? But those have been the challenges. And then just trying to keep everybody safe. You know, the hotel stuff's been weird, where, you know, you can only do so many things, and where you got to meet and how you got to have your food and where you got to, it's just a different thing that everybody has to adjust to.
For a lot of teams, usually those team meals are a bonding experience. Have you been able to figure out a way to still do those team meals, or is it pretty much players go their separate ways after they're able to get the food?
Well, we try to do those bonding things. I love that. You know, even like when it wasn't COVID, we'd go to a restaurant and we all sit together and we all talk and do things. That's how you get to meet your team and know your team. You find out a lot of fun stuff about your players during those meals, and vice versa. They find out about us. I love those. So we try to do those at the hotel. You know, we rent, get the conference room and do that. But like I said, some hotels, we can't do that. They won't let us mingle. Like we're up in Denver and you can only have, you know, 7 to a group. You know, we don't have 7 in a group. So that one we had to grab our meals from the conference room and go back to your room. So we didn't like that as much, but some of the hotels have been great that we have the conference room and we can all get together and have dinner and talk talk about the game plan as well. So we like those.
Well, you mentioned being at home, and you're 3-1 at home. So as they say, there's no place quite like home. What makes Burns Arena so good to play, even in a limited amount of fans?
Well, again, the fans are the number one, but at least we have fans in there, which I like. The other thing is just getting in a routine. You know, they're used to being in the same bed. They're used to eating the same time, school. We have school on Friday, so they're used to that. You know, and just going through the normal routines. And it's, you kind of know what's going to work and what, you know, like last week, another good example is our bus. You know, we have to charter a bus, and the bus guy's late. You know, and so we get to a shootaround, and it's not an excuse why we lost, but just those kind of things that you don't have to worry about. You don't have to worry about, is the bus going to be on time? Are we going to be able to get in the gym on time? Is our guys going to get treatment on time? You know, it's just home. It's just kind of a routine, and everybody knows what to do and how to do it.
You have a Red Hot Lopes team coming into Burns Arena this weekend. What's the number one thing that needs to happen for you to win that series?
You got to score more points. No, they're good. You know, we try to focus on the team we're playing, obviously. And last week we saw a few things on, but not trying to jump ahead. But we've seen them play Arizona State. We saw some of those games when we weren't playing. We tried to watch everybody play as much as possible. But, man, they're good. Drew's doing a great job with them. I knew a new coaching change with them, but they have all other players back. They're big. They have the size, they have the quickness, they have the athletic. I mean, how many times we see their guy on top 10 plays of the week throwing it off the glass? I mean, they're really good. I watching them on tape and all the teams, I think they, even though they weren't picked to win it, I think they got a really good chance of winning what they have. So we know we got our hands full. You know, we've played them in the past when we were Division II. But back then we played them in a small gym. It was a different coach. And then even when they built their new gym and we played in that, obviously it's a whole different thing. So, you know, this Division I's been interesting for us. You know, I think we got a great team for Division II. We're just not, I don't think we're ready yet for Division I, but that's what we're here for. That's our first year. We're trying to get better and we're trying to learn from these other guys and learn from. So we're excited to play. There's no question about that, but we know we got to play really good to beat them.
You mentioned playing them at the D2 level. Well, you got the record on your side, Coach, 12-4 against the Lopes, dating all the way back to 2007. What game sticks out in your mind from that time period?
There's too many. You know, like I said, the old gym was crazy how it was rocking loud and crazy. Then they built that new gym. I remember one game that we were up. I think we were up one with 8 seconds left. They had the ball and we talked about switching all screens and one of our guys didn't listen, I guess, and did switch and they hit a wide open shot in the corner with at the buzzer to beat us. I mean, just things like that. They've always been great games. And we normally get a good turnout when we go down there to play them. We have a lot of alumni that live in the Arizona area and we had a great turnout in those games. And we hope we in the future when we go back there that, you know, we have a good following of our fans, because it's always been a great contest with them and also with Cal Baptist, who was also in our Division II times. So we're excited, but it's a whole different thing because they have different players, obviously, but also different coaches. So it's a whole different game plan.
You mentioned playing the back-to-back games last weekend against UTRGV. What did you learn from that past weekend that can help you prepare for Saturday's game?
Well, what I've learned, like I said, it's hard because of injuries. That's why we voted for it. We wanted the Thursday night game and then a Saturday afternoon game just to give them that day to heal. But I get it. I get why for the COVID reasons. But I thought that we had a chance. If you're playing the same team twice, your chances of COVID would have been fine and you could have that extra day. It would have been so nice because there's not a lot you can do. I mean, obviously, we spent a lot more time Saturday watching film and showing them things that we didn't do well on Friday and things that they took away from us. So to me, it's more of a strategy game that way with film and then try to get out there and do it. But it's a quick turnaround. And the teams that have a deeper bench, it helps them. It helps pay off because they don't play as many minutes or whatever. But right now, our guys are playing 30-something minutes. And so it's really a tough thing for us. But the good thing is everybody's doing it, you know, and as long as they're doing that, then I think it's fair. But it's definitely hard. It's definitely a challenge.
Guard Cameron Gooden leads the team in points. And we know he obviously can shoot baskets. But tell me, what's one thing that people may not know about him?
Great leader. Great point guard. How he's kind of like our coach on the floor. I mean, he understands the game. Most of the guys I get in, the JC transfers or freshmen coming in, the new first-year guys, it takes him a while to catch on. Boy, he's caught on right away. Very, very intelligent IQ, basketball IQ, understands the game very well. We did some things different with him on Saturday, and I think it helped him. But just a competitor. He wants to win so bad. I mean, he's one of those guys that's playing 35 minutes a game. And, you know, we pull him out and say, hey, get a quick rest. He goes, Coach, I'm ready. I want to go back in. You know, and they just don't realize that, you know, 2 or 3 minute rest helps them a lot. But I love that in a kid that wants to be out there, that wants to compete, that wants to win. And that's the kind of guys we want in our program. And he's a great example of that. For us to making this move to Division I, he's a big part of that. And we hope that we can get more players like him in the future.
Well, Coach, we have certainly enjoyed watching him as well. And best of luck against GCU this weekend.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me on.
Dixie State men's basketball coach Jon Judkins. When we come back to the Road to WAC Vegas, we're going to take a look at women's hoops for this upcoming week.